Hey everybody, it's Dr. Vanessa, the people's nephrologist. Don't be alarmed, it's just my black girl summer hair that I got going on. But I wanted to talk with you about a comment that I saw in a discussion about my last video. Basically, why don't they tell us until we have stage 3 chronic kidney disease? I think that's a good question and one that I wanted to clear up for anyone else who's wondering the same thing. And I will say that I can't speak for every doctor why we don't say things sooner. I think it's in part, we don't want to create unnecessary anxiety and worry. And I think we don't want to be so negative all the time. You think about people just in my comments for this YouTube channel. I've been called a Debbie Downer. Everything is so negative. Why can't I be hopeful? And, you know, I'm about giving accurate information. And to me, that's where the hope is, knowing how to make better decisions for yourself and your health. Okay. And I think the other reason is that we don't really see any clinical limitations are, signs until the person gets to stage 3. But I do agree, we should let people should understand sooner so they can act sooner. And as long as we're explaining things properly, it doesn't have to be a state of high anxiety. Okay, but you should know that stage 1, chronic kidney disease, just means you have a risk factor. You can have completely normal GFR, the glomerular filtration rate, but you have a risk factor like diabetes or high blood pressure, or there's some hereditary problem for kidneys in your family. You automatically have stage 1. If you do have high blood pressure or diabetes, then what can you do? You can really work on controlling those with the diet and medication so that your kidney function doesn't get worse. Okay. Stage 2 would mean that your GFR is down a little bit, or you have some elevated protein in your urine, specifically the albumin to creatinine ratio is above 30. Now, of course, there's different levels of risk if your that albumin to creatinine ratio is higher than 300. So that makes the point too that just because you're in a stage of CKD doesn't mean that you're the same as everybody in that stage. It's more for kind of knowing what is going on with the population than the individual. So for example, someone with stage 3, that goes from a GFR of 30 to 59. So of course somebody with a GFR of 58 is not at the same risk for going on to kidney failure or the complications of kidney disease like heart problems as somebody who has a GFR of say 35. And then of course stage 4 goes from 15 to 30, and stage 5 is under 15. And another point I should make is that when we say chronic kidney disease, that means that it's been evaluated and about the same over a 3-month period. So if something sudden happens and your creatinine gets worse, but that thing is taken away and the kidneys are able to recover, then that is acute kidney injury. That doesn't count as chronic kidney disease. And there's some debate going on if just having an episode of acute kidney disease puts you at risk for developing chronic kidney disease later on. And the most recent recommendations are that someone see a nephrologist when that GFR gets down to 30 or less. Of course, there's other reasons that beyond just the GFR that a person should be referred sooner, like high blood pressure that the primary doctor can't get under control, or blood in the urine microscopic levels that we know aren't coming from the bladder, things like that. But in the general chronic kidney disease, it's recommended see a nephrologist once that GFR is 30. I personally think that's too late, And in part, I feel like that recommendation is because of the workforce. There's so many people who have GFR under 60 that we just simply don't have enough nephrologists to see all those folks. But I do think 30 is just too late. As a primary care doctor, and I'm practicing a little primary care now, I may not know all of the things that I could be doing to prevent a person's kidney disease from worsening. So I think it would be helpful if folks saw someone before the kidney function got to that level, so that the nephrologist could just double check and make sure everything possible that could be done to prevent further worsening of kidney function is being done, give those recommendations. And the last thing I wanted to share are my own numbers. I get my kidney function checked around my birthday every year. My birthday's June 3rd, Gemini. Because I'm a kidney donor. So I'm down to one kidney, so that automatically means I'm at higher risk than someone who has two normally functioning kidneys. I didn't do my kidney anniversary video this time around my numbers because my website was a mess and I didn't want to send people to it, but now it's looking really great. I'm quite proud of it. And please have a look when you have time, thenephrologist.com. And our 18th kidney transplant anniversary was way back in April. and the recipient, my husband, is doing great. And I have no regrets, even though, as you can see from my numbers, that I have a slightly elevated creatinine. That means that my GFR is estimated at 55. So technically, I do have stage 3 chronic kidney disease. Now, before surgery, if I recall correctly, my creatinine was 0.8. And after surgery, it went up to 1.2. And in the 18 years since then, it's been between 1.10 and 1.20. And my albumin to creatinine ratio is normal. So I'm not upset that I technically have stage 3 kidney disease. I have no regrets about donating a kidney to someone that I love and felt like needed to be able to thrive, and I could help that. So no regrets. What I am doing now is making sure that I work on these extra pandemic and perimenopause pounds that I've put on so that I don't develop diabetes or high blood pressure, which could threaten what kidney function I do have. But my GFR of 55 is, I'm good. And you should know that it's not the death sentence that most people are afraid of. So my plan is to keep checking my kidney function every year and staying as healthy as I can. And that's what I encourage you all to do as well. All right. That's all for now. Let me know what you think. And if you have any questions, definitely share, subscribe, and take good care. Bye.